It has been 3 years since Subaru discontinued the Tribeca. When it was first introduced more than 10 years ago as the B9 Tribeca, it was the Japanese auto manufacturer's first mid-size SUV. By comparison, Subaru has been selling the Forester, its smaller SUV, for the last 20 years. Built on the Legacy's platform, the Tribeca, like all Subaru models at the time, was powered by a boxer engine and equipped with all-wheel drive. Unlike the rest of the lineup, however, it simply did not sell. In the United States, the car maker managed to move less than 80,000 total units from dealership lots. In its final year, less than 1,000 Tribecas were sold. After scrapping the Tribeca, Subaru is now ready for redemption. Initially previewed at the New York International Auto Show in concept form, the production Ascent will finally be revealed at the end of this month. Made exclusively for the North American market, the Ascent will fill the hole in Subaru's current offerings. Demand for crossovers has increased in recent years, forcing companies to scramble to meet consumers' needs. Details are scarce, but the Ascent will be powered by an all-new turbocharged direct injection boxer engine. The engine is rumored to be a 2.4-liter four-cylinder producing 300 horsepower. With the addition of the third row, the Ascent will be able to seat up to 7 passengers. For the Ascent's sake, let's hope Subaru can fill all of those seats when the car goes on sale next year.
As the 2018 Nissan Leaf enters the production, Leaf owners discuss whether purchasing is a better idea versus leasing. Many Nissan Leaf owners are somewhat disappointed that the 2018 Leaf doesn't have at least 200 miles of range per charge. Those who have leased a Nissan Leaf say they have been hanging on to their leases in promise of that range. "We want to own and be done with payments. We have been loyal enough," writes Jesse Lindsay in Leaf Owners public group on Facebook. Here is what determines the residual value of Nissan Leaf. One group member responds to what's better in terms of buying versus leasing MEV and favors the leasing. Here is why. "At this point in the evolution of EVs, purchasing one is a bad idea. Leasing is the best way to use an EV at least until 2022, simply because the technology continues to improve and the costs continue to drop. I have had two Leafs since 2011, both were leased, and my total out-of-pocket costs have been less than $5,000, plus I get to drive the latest iteration of the car. EVs today are at the same point that PCs were in the 1990s, they continue to get better and cheaper, so why get stuck with car when you can get a fresh one that is better and cheaper with your total cost of ownership being the same? If you really think you need more range, then yes, wait a few months, chances are that you are doing just fine with what you currently have," writes Gary Lieber in the group. And to your point about a 2018 Leaf that no one wants, you will be surprised when Nissan announces that they have almost all of their 2018 capacity already pre-sold, Lieber adds. "I am not sure about leasing, as I have never leased a car. I remember one of our college professors warned against leasing, as you always keep paying and never owning. Also, you keep paying for interest. So, I always like to buy only things I can afford and purchase."
Nissan's all-new Leaf has won its first international award at the Consumer Electronics Show, CES. The 100% electric vehicle with ProPilot and e-pedal technologies has claimed honors like CES Best of Innovation Award winner for vehicle intelligence and self-driving technology, and CES honoree for tech for a better world. The Consumer Technology Association has announced the Best of Innovation Award winners for 2018 in New York, as part of the build-up to the January CES in Las Vegas. The Japanese car manufacturer Nissan claims that the new Leaf offers a complete package of everyday useful innovations and technologies for its buyers. The new Nissan Leaf will be showcased at the CES 2018, and although the vehicle is currently on sale in the Japanese market, it will arrive in US and Canada dealerships over the next 2 months. Speaking on the occasion, Danielle Schilacci, Nissan's Executive Vice President for Global Marketing and Sales, said, "It is a great honor to have this early and important recognition for the new Nissan Leaf. This award recognizes products and technologies that benefit people and the planet, so it is fitting that the new Leaf has been honored. It is more than just a car. It is the icon of Nissan Intelligent Mobility, our vision to move people to a better world."
Lately, there's been a lot of talk about autonomous or self-driving cars. On the one hand, this seems like more Jetsons-inspired nonsense, kind of like the flying car. On the other hand, many automakers are actually building cars that can assist the driver in various ways. Brands like Cadillac, Ford, Nissan, Subaru and Volvo are doing a lot of the talking about the technology and how their own products fit into the conversation. Good communication essentially equals success. If you don't communicate your idea properly, you might as well just not do it. For example, Nissan is doing such a good job of letting the press and public know about some of their emerging technology that they've become the de facto winner in the race toward driver assist and, eventually, totally self-driving cars. Is their tech the best? Will it be the first? I don't know, maybe, maybe not. It doesn't really matter. The fact is, they're shouting about it so loudly that you kind of have to pay attention. Thankfully, the shouting is backed up by useful, real-world, autonomous technology, and it's already working in some vehicles. However, it's important to keep in mind that society, roads, regulations and insurance all have to be ready too. It's not just about the cars. In a recent automotive news article, former auto industry executive Bob Lutz describes an automotive future where cars enter and exit highways, merge and navigate superhighways automatically. He says that spells the end of the traditional automobile as we know it. He's partly right. I'm not sure about the timeline, but I've seen Nissan vehicles negotiate the real world exactly like Lutz describes. I sat in the back seat of an Infiniti Q70 equipped with a sophisticated version of Nissan's ProPilot technology. The car was able to get itself from one navigation point to the other with very little human interaction. That interaction included the human driver entering the destination into the car's onboard navigation system, something that could easily be accomplished with a smartphone, and raising the car's set cruise control speed to see if it would pass a slower car, because we asked the driver to do it. It did. This was not done on a closed course but rather in Tokyo on surface streets and highways, including highway on ramps and exits in both left and right turns. I suspect the driver was unnecessary and was there primarily to ease nerves. Nissan also demonstrated a Leaf EV that can park itself, but this requires a little more human supervision. There is one little caveat. This was done in Tokyo, where most streets and roads are very clearly marked and easy to understand, even for cameras. Some lanes are even color-coded. Also, the speed limits are a little lower on the highways there. In many cases, the posted limits were 60 to 80 kilometers per hour, roughly 40 to 50 miles per hour. It's as controlled an environment as you can get and still be in the real world. There were three of us in this one self-driving car. For the first 10 minutes, we sat amazed that the car was driving itself and negotiating real-world traffic. Then, as quickly as it started, it became normal. The conversation went like this. "Wow, so the car knows there's a red light? And it just passed that slower car? Cool. Hey, did you guys see the gigantic tower records in the heart of Tokyo? I spent 2 hours there last night. They have everything from..." And just like that, we accepted that the car in which we were riding was, essentially, driving itself. I expect the rest of the world will have the same reaction. Later, at the Tokyo Auto Show, I asked Danielle Schilacci, EVP Global Marketing and Sales for Nissan, how long it would be before such a car could be ready for consumers in the real world. His answer is somewhat nuanced, just beyond 2022 to 2023 for full autonomous in specific cities. That answer is both overly optimistic and a little conservative at the same time. In cities like Las Vegas, San Francisco or Chicago, where the downtown area is rather well defined, it could be sooner. I'm picturing vehicles on a loop of sorts, maybe even similar to San Francisco's mini trolley buses that are already bound to specific streets, because they run off overhead electrified cables. The bus technology already exists in the form of Ollie. How long until the average shopper can go buy a car that drives itself part of the time with the infrastructure of an entire state or even country supporting it? I think that's much farther out, perhaps as much as 15 to 18 years. To that end, Nissan showed a concept car in Tokyo. It's called the INX. It has a steering wheel and pedals that can stow out of the way when the car drives itself. Optimistic? Sure, but that's the fun of concept cars, and kudos to Nissan for creating such a forward-looking concept in the first place. Note to automakers, no one wants to come to your press conference to hear executives talk about net gains, EBITDA and sales goals only to see a concept car that looks 90% like a production car, take Nissan's lead, and show the world something amazing. To be fair, other automakers like Ford, General Motors and Volvo are working on similar tech as an extension of their driver assist features, many of which are already available on new cars today. Nissan is getting ahead of the game by developing and, more importantly, communicating their vision of the future of the automobile. If I had to guess, I'd say Nissan has the will, ability, desire and dealer network to become the go-to source for cars that will eventually drive themselves.